Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here, one of my favorite authors. I don't always agree with him, but I do always appreciate his viewpoint because he's a radical libertarian. Lawrence Vance, PhD. And this is considered to be like one of the most definitive books on the King James Version. He is a scholar of the top sort. And I had the first issue of this, and I just saw that they come out with a second. Now, I'll show you what I mean by authoritative. His numbers for the number of verses, chapters, middle verse, words in each book, they are considered to be the authoritative. So you'll see a ton of different things like this on the internet. But this is the authoritative look at those numbers. And it just he's like David Cloud. His breadth of knowledge that he brings to this is absolutely incredible. So King James and the Throne of England, the Hampton Court Conference, which I've got the actual notes of the Hampton Court Conference, fascinating. The making of the King James Bible, an authorized version in Tyndale, the learned men, Giles Lawrence, King James translator, you know, the Bodleian Bishop's Bible, the story of John Boyce's notes, which I've got that here, which I'll probably do at another point. Purified seven times, mistakes in the authorized version, so-called mistakes, origin of King James onlyism, King James onlyism in Scotland. I mean, just incredible. And so he would be a King James guy, a massive King James guy. But I appreciate that he deals very honestly with all of the various controversies out there. And so I greatly appreciate that. And let's see how long this book is. It is, with the bibliography, which is extensive, it is 374 pages. So this is a book I'd highly recommend. I think I read it in its other iteration. I haven't read it in this iteration yet with the 12 added essays. But they are just fantastic. I'll let you see on the back. So something I would highly recommend, Larry Vance, King James, his Bible, and its translators. So God bless you. I hope you have the greatest day and the greatest week you've ever had in the name of Jesus. I'd encourage you to get saved if you're not saved. Get born again of water and spirit. Don't take the words of man. Take the words of God. Hallelujah. Talk with you later in Jesus' name.